All right, now next up we have Troy Lum, who is the founder of Hopscotch, and it's a name that you've probably heard very often. It's a distribution company, also a production company that has really helped bring a lot of fantastic independent films to Australian audiences. So I'll let Troy take it away.
Hi there. Hello?
Hi.
Hi, I'm Troy from Hopscotch. I started the company in around 2003, and it started off with just me and my business partner, Sandy Don, and we didn't really have much to go on, just our instincts. We both ran Dendy for a number of years. I was about 24, I think 26 or 27 when I started Hopscotch. I was 21 when I started in the film business, in distribution. And I've never actually done anything else. So it's quite interesting. I mean, this seminar poses this question about commerciality and being true to your artistic instincts, which is something that I need to battle with every day. The kind of difficult thing about the business I'm in is that the barometer for success is box office, and so it's very, very public. And it's all about money. And but I don't think you can survive in the business for as long as we have. And you know, this is my 15th year in distribution. I don't think you can survive in there if your only focus is money. But mind you, when you have 30 staff, you're quickly reminded that your main goal is to make sure that you keep all those people in employment. And that means that you have to make decisions that ultimately mean making money. Or at least breaking even. What I do is I'm a film buyer and a film producer. So my main role is it sounds very glamorous, to go around the world to various film festivals. I do about 6 or 7 a year, and I find films to bring back here. So I buy the rights to films. I buy the rights for usually around 15 to 20 years. And it's sort of like buying real estate, and my job is basically to bring those films back here and to turn those contracts into campaigns to get people to go and see those movies. So we have to find the cinemas to play the films. We have to do the whole marketing campaign. We have to do the advertising, the publicity. The risk involved in releasing a film in Australia is, at its low end, about $150,000, and at its top end, around $1.5 to $2 million. To acquire a movie is somewhere between, you can buy films at as little as $40,000, and you can buy films for as high as $2 million. Obviously, when we started out, our main aim was to try to find, you know, the little diamonds in the rough, and try to turn those into big films. And at the time that we came into the market, that was a real possibility, and you could do that. As time has evolved, and the brand has evolved, we've obviously tried to always stick to a sort of, we have instincts to that we want to deliver stuff that is really good and has artistic value. And as time has moved on, we've had to balance that with having films with real commercial value, because you know, being able to do other kinds of films for artistic or political or social reasons are really a luxury. The main thing is to try to find a balance between making money and making money from things that you can really, you know, swallow. I don't really love all the films that I release. I think if I released all the films that I really loved, I wouldn't have a business anymore. You become very, you know, in a marketplace. I'll probably see 6 or 7 films a day from, you know, all over the world, from varying degrees of usually pretty bad ones. And, you're kind of in and out. I mean, I usually give a film about 45 minutes. And if it's not very good, I've got to leave because I've got another film to go to, a meeting to go to. As time has evolved, I've got a team of 5 buyers, so we we go to all these festivals together, and that's kind of evolved mainly because it's really hard to trust your own taste after so many years, because I've got so many, you're kind of working from precedence all the time, and you've got so many films that don't work and so many films that do work, and most of the time the films that you buy don't work. And so over years and years and years, you become quite cynical about the business. So it's really, really important to have different voices, younger voices, people of a different gender, who are giving you different perspectives about what's good, because to be honest, it does become quite blurry. And a lot of, you know, over the years, a lot of people have said that, you know, I'm a really great buyer, which means I've got really good taste in movies. And I think that's it's a little bit of a myth, because the market's very competitive and there's a lot of great buyers and a lot of people know what a great movie is. The real skill is not necessarily knowing what a great movie is. The great skill is knowing how to get it, having the relationship to make the deal and know how much to pay for it. So I'm just going to show a little clip, which is something that we show, because the main thing I've got to do first when I bring these films home is to get cinemas to play it, which is a lot harder than that may seem. But I'm going to show you a clip that we showed them, which will also give you a little intro into the company.
I almost wish we were butterflies and lived but three summer days. Three such days with you I could fill with more delight than 50 common years could ever contain.
Pleasure is all mine.
Oh, you're American.
She's scandalous.
Oh!
I'd like to invite you both to come with me for the weekend. We'll eat well, we'll drink good wine, we'll make love.
Stop worrying about growing old. Worry about growing up.
I ordered you a gimlet. I know you don't drink in the afternoon, but you will eventually, so why not start now?
You know, the only place I get hurt is out there.
I'm here. I'm really here.
Okay, so that was just something we presented for the crop of films that we had last year. So what I really want to talk about here is not so much doing things for other reasons other than to make money, but I just think it's not good business just to do things to make money. And I think what you need to have is a suite of reasons about why you do things and have all those conspire to create a business, because I think if your main aim is only to make money, then that would mean that I think you have to do some pretty dodgy things. You have to get out of deals, you have to break relationships, you've got to do things pretty ruthlessly in my business if your eye is completely just on the bottom line all the time. So the way that I see why I get involved in a movie, whether it's to produce a film or distribute a film, is obviously, first of all, is it going to make any money? Does it have an audience? Because there's nothing sadder, trust me, than buying a film that you really love that no one goes to see. I don't get any pleasure out of that. It's actually really demoralising.